Do your minions leave trash everywhere? Do pesky adventurers obstruct your plans for world domination? I've got a simple solution for your two problems at once. Bring an ooze into your lair and you're guaranteed to have a decluttered space for your bringing of the apocalypse!
Welcome back to Compendium of Monsters. It's Gelatinous Cube Week. Before we continue, slap that subscribe button, but be careful. It could easily be a cube in disguise. Gelatinous cubes are challenge level 2, and they can be quite deadly against a standard party of level 2 adventurers. These large oozes have an armor class of 6, average hit points of 84, a speed of 15 feet, and blindsight out to 60 feet beyond which it is blind. Would it surprise you to learn that oozes can speak a language? Yep. It would surprise me too. Gelatinous cubes have the ooze cube ability. If a creature enters the gelatinous cube space, it must make a saving throw against getting engulfed, and the saving throw is made with disadvantage. Luckily, ooze cube means creatures contained inside the gelatinous cube have total cover. With total cover, a creature cannot be targeted by an attack or a spell, though can still be included in areas of effect. Because that's your main concern, right? Not getting attacked by outside forces while something is literally trying to digest you. A gelatinous cube can hold up to 4 medium creatures or 1 large creature at a time, though allies on the outside can take an action to pull a creature out of the cube with a strength check. Whether a success or a failure, the ally will take an average of 10 acid damage. Look, if your entire party of 4 ends up in a gelatinous cube and you all die there, you deserve it. The cube was best suited to survive. In case you don't already have overly suspicious player characters in your game,
suspicious duck!
Gelatinous cubes are transparent. Despite being notorious for hauling around varying amounts of metal, treasure, and other inorganic materials, gelatinous cubes can almost hide in plain sight. To spot a stationary cube that has neither attacked nor moved, a player must succeed on a perception check.
Suspicion!
Any creatures that move into the gelatinous cube space unaware of its presence are surprised. That's the nice way of saying the gelatinous cube has advantage to attack you and your first turn is forfeit. This is not a good surprise! For their attack, gelatinous cubes can slap a with their nasty, wet, slimy pseudopod, which deals an average of 10 acid damage. This is 2/3 the expected damage from a challenge level 2 creature, but gelatinous cubes have ways to make up for it. If a gelatinous cube is feeling spicy, it can instead choose to engulf one or more nearby targets. A gelatinous cube will move up to its movement speed and force any creatures whose spaces it enters to make a dexterity saving throw. Creatures who succeed are pushed 5 feet away. Creatures who fail take an average of 10 acid damage and are moved into the gelatinous cube's slimy body. An engulfed creature cannot breathe, is restrained, is forced to move with the gelatinous cube, and takes an average of 21 acid damage at the start of each of the cube's turns. If your character is about to get engulfed, you should use a free action to hold your breath. Just be aware you'll red flag for metagaming if it's your first encounter with an ooze and you hold your breath before anyone is engulfed. Since suffocation rules are relevant here, holding your breath gives you a number of minutes of air equal to 1 plus your constitution modifier. The minimum is 30 seconds, so don't worry too much about those negative con mods. 30 seconds is 5 rounds, which should be more than enough for you to escape. If you don't prepare your breath or run out of air, you can survive for a number of rounds equal to your constitution modifier or a minimum of 1 round before you drop to 0 hit points and are dying. A creature dropped to 0 hit points in this fashion cannot regain hit points nor make death saving throws until it can breathe again. Fortunately, there are two ways this can be solved. First, the engulfed creature can use its action to attempt a strength check to free itself into an unoccupied space of its choice within 5 feet of the gelatinous cube. Second, even if the engulfed creature drops to 0 hit points and is dying, it will only fail 2 of 3 death saving throws during the next turn. That gives plenty of opportunities for friends to come and attempt strength checks to drag the victim out of the gelatinous cube's body. And if your so-called friends abandon you to die inside a gelatinous cube, it's the perfect opportunity for your DM to spawn a revenant under your control. Unless you deserved it, in which case, make better choices next time. Gelatinous cubes are born from the Faceless Lord, the Oozing Hunger, the Demon Lord Dweeblex. Dweeblex consumes organic matter and transforms it into an endless supply of oozes. As is typical of demon lords, Dweeblex is delighted to send minions through portals when an opportunity presents itself, though oozes outside of Dweeblex's influence are significantly stupider. Hence the gelatinous cube's nickname,
Dungeon Roomba!
Not comparable to Naughty Nunu, gelatinous cubes wander dungeons and pick up everything in their path. It's not a concern as to whether or not they can consume the matter, their focus is on quantity over quality. This does beg the question as to what happens to a gelatinous cube that is filled up on inorganic, indigestible contents. Despite having an intelligence score of less than mouth breather, oozes are driven by hunger and hypothetically are wise enough to regurgitate undigested matter once every great while. Though, honestly, I'm not sure oozes live long enough to amass a large collection of inorganic matter. Once you start killing creatures in a community, they typically strike back, hire adventurers to take you out, or hire adventurers and join them in destroying you a la Imrith.
Gelatinous cubes scour dungeon passages in silent, predictable patterns, leaving perfectly clean paths in their wake. They consume living tissue while leaving bones and other materials undissolved.
Okay. A creature with an intelligence score of 1 is not going to move in predictable patterns. Similarly to you when you're drunk off your ass, it barely knows which way is up and probably couldn't find it if not for gravity. Also, gelatinous cubes consume living tissue but not bone, but why? Wizards? Don't you people know bone is considered living tissue? Or is it more about the spectacle of bones present in the ooze as it shuffles around a dungeon space? Because while I get it, you could have gone beyond the bare minimum and said something like,
the gelatinous cube consumes a victim's flesh, organs, and even marrow, but mysteriously leaves bone intact.
But then, I suppose you'd have to spend money on riders. Hadozi, anyone?
A gelatinous cube is all but transparent, making it hard to spot until it attacks. A cube that is well-fed can be easier to spot, since its victim's bones, coins, and other objects can be seen suspended inside the creature.
So it's difficult to see, except when it's not difficult to see because it's lugging around the contents of its former meals. Unless a player character is recklessly sprinting through a dungeon, the only way I see a gelatinous cube sneaking up on a party is if it follows one that comes into its space. Even then, a gelatinous cube has a -4 to its stealth rolls. It's not gonna sneak up on anyone ever.
Not like Badekas.
Oozes thrive in the dark, shunning areas of bright light and extreme temperatures.
But why? This is immediately contradicted barely 3 sentences later with,
oozes are drawn to movement and warmth.
It's not like gelatinous cubes have sunlight sensitivity or any elemental weaknesses. Bright light typically means food is nearby, especially in the Underdark.
An ooze kills its prey slowly. Some varieties, such as black puddings and gelatinous cubes, engulf creatures to prevent escape. The only upside of this torturous death is that a victim's comrades can come to the rescue before it is too late.
Bold of you to assume a creature too stupid to know which way is up will play with their food. Also, oozes are constantly hungry. Why would a gelatinous cube risk having its food escape or another creature come steal its food? Gelatinous cubes might just be that dumb, but if so, I find it boring. Anyways, what do you think of gelatinous cubes? Have you ever had a character consumed by one? Let me know in the comments below. A special thank you to my incredible patrons. And thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share my video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and make the leap to become one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you next time.